people around the globe, everywhere you are. If you're in the west side, the east side, the south side, the north side, Canada, England, Australia, Africa, the motherland. Shoot, if you're right here with me in Charleston, South Carolina, I just want to say good day. And I love you guys just for putting time into your purpose and for your life. Thank you, Father God, for this day and for this moment. I praise you and I honor you. And I need you. Because it ain't easy. But I still want to live for you. Even when I realize it ain't easy, I still want to work for you. I still want to be a part of your kingdom and serve you the right way. Forgive me for my sins and help me where I'm weak, Father God. I love you and I thank you. And let's get into the reading. Today we will be reading from the book of Zephaniah. Excuse me, let me correct my pronunciation. It is Zephaniah. Don't drag me, guys. Zephaniah. Chapters 1 through 3. Chapter 1. The Lord will judge the earth. Child, let's circle that. Okay. The word of the Lord which came unto Zephaniah, the son of Kashah, the son of Gedaliah, the son of Amariah, the son of Hezekiah, in the days of Josiah, the son of Ammon, and the king of Judah. I will utterly consume all things from all the land, said the Lord. I will utterly consume all things from off the land, said the Lord. I will consume man and beast. I will consume the fowls of the heaven and the fishes of the sea and the stumbling blocks from the wicked. And I will cut off man from off the land, said the Lord. The Lord will judge Judah, and I will also stretch out my hand upon Judah and upon all the inhabitants of Jerusalem. And I will cut off the raiments of Baal from this place, and the name of the Shemarims with the priest. Verse 5, and them that worship the host of heaven upon the housetops, and them that worship and that swear by the Lord, and that swear by Malachim, and them that are turned back from the Lord, and those that have not sought the Lord, nor inquired for him. Hold thy peace at the presence of the Lord God, for the day of the Lord is at hand. For the Lord had prepared a sacrifice, and he had bid his guest. And it shall come to pass in the day of the Lord's sacrifice that I will punish the princes and the king's children, and all such as are clothed with strange apparel. And the same day also which I will punish all those that leap on the threshold, which fold their master's houses with violence and deceit. And it shall come to pass in that day, said the Lord, that there shall be a noise of a cry from the fish gate, and a howling from the second, and a great crashing from the hills. How, ye inhabitants of Maktesh, from all the merchants, people are cut down, and all they that bear silver are cut off. And it shall come to pass at that time that I will search Jerusalem with candles and punish the men that are settled on their less. That they say in their heart that the Lord will not do good, neither will he do evil. Therefore their goods shall become a booty, and their houses a desolation, and they shall also build houses, but not inhabit them. And they shall plant vineyards, but not drink wine thereof. The day of the Lord, the great day of the Lord is near. It is near. And haste greatly, even the voice of the day of the Lord. The mighty man shall cry there bitterly. That day is a day of wrath, a day of trouble and distress, a day of wasteness and desolation, a day of darkness and gloominess, a day of clouds and thick darkness, a day of the trumpet and alarm against defense cities and against high towers. And I will bring distress upon men, that they shall walk like blind men, because they have sinned against the Lord, and their blood shall be poured out as dust, and their flesh as the dung. Neither their silver nor their gold shall be able to deliver them in the day of the Lord's wrath. But the whole land shall be devoured by the fire of his jealousy. For he shall make even a speedy riddance of all them that dwell in the land. Chapter 2. The exhortation to repentance. Gather yourselves today. Gather yourselves together. Yeah, gather yourselves together, O nations not desired. Before the decree bring forth, before the day pass as the chaff, before the fierce anger of the Lord come upon you, before the day of the Lord's anger come upon you, seek ye the Lord, ye meek of the earth, which have wrought his judgment. Seek righteousness, seek meekness. It may be ye shall be hid in the day of the Lord's anger. It may be ye shall be hid in the days of the Lord's anger. The Lord will judge his people's enemies. For Gaza shall be forsaken, and Ashkelon a desolation, and they shall drive out Ashdod at the noonday, and Ekron shall be rooted up. Woe unto the inhabitants of the sea's coast, the nations of the Asherethites. The word of the Lord is against you, O Canaan, the land of the Philistines. I will even destroy thee, that there shall be no inhabitant, and the sea coast shall be dwellings, and cottages for the shepherds, and folds for the flocks. And the coast shall be for the raiment of the house of Judah, and they shall feed thereupon in the houses of Ashkelon. Shall they lie down in the evening, for the Lord their God shall visit them, and turn away their captivity. And I have heard the reproach of Moab, and I have heard the reproach of Moab and the revilings of the children of Ammon, whereby they have reproached my people and magnified themselves against their border. Therefore, as I live, said the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, surely Moab shall be as Sodom, and the children of Ammon as Gomorrah. What that mean, y'all? In verse 9, it says, therefore, as I live, said the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, surely Moab shall be as Sodom, and the children of Ammon as Gomorrah. Even the breeding of nettles and cell pits and perpetual desolations, the residue of my people shall spoil them, and the raiment of my people shall possess them. This shall they have for their pride, because they have reproached and magnified themselves against the peoples of the Lord's host. The Lord will be terrible unto them, For he will famish all the gods of the earths, and men shall worship him, every one from his place, even all the isles of the heathen. Ye Ethiopians, also ye shall be slain by my sword. And he will stretch out his hand against the north and destroy Assyria, and will make Nineveh a desolation, and dry like a wilderness, and flocks shall lie down in the midst of her. And the beast of the nations, both of the cormorant and the bittern shall lodge in the upper lintels of it. Their voice shall sing in the windows. Desolation shall be in the thresholds, for he shall uncover the cedar work. This is the rejoicing city that dwelt carelessly, that said in her heart, I am, there is none beside me. How has she become a desolation, a place for the beast to lie down in? Everyone that passed by her shall hiss and wag his hand. Chapter 3. A sharp reproof for Jerusalem. Woe to her that is filthy and polluted, to the oppressing city. She obeyed not the voice. She received not the correction. She trusted not in the Lord. She drew not near to her God. Her princes were in her. Her are reproaching lions. Her judges are even fox. Oh my God. Let me start over. Verse 3 in chapter 3. Her princes wherein her are roaring lions. Her judges are even wolves. They gnaw not the bones to the marrow. Her prophets are light and treacherous persons. Her priests have polluted the sanctuary, and they have done violence to the law. The just Lord is in the midst thereof, and he will not do iniquity. Every morning do he bring his judgment to light. He fail not, but the unjust know no shame. I have cut off the nations. Their towers are desolate. I made their streets waste, that none pass by. Their cities are destroyed, so that there is no man, that there is none inhabitant. And I said, surely, thou wilt fear me, and thou wilt receive instructions, so their dwellings should not be cut off. However, I punished them, but they rose early and corrupted all their doings. Wait for Israel's restoration. Therefore wait ye upon me, said the Lord, until the day that I rise up to the prey. For my determination is to gather the nations, that I may assemble the kingdoms to pour upon them mine indignation, even all my fierce anger. For all the earth shall be devoured with the fire of my jealousy. For then will I turn to the people of pure language, that they may all call upon the name of the Lord, to serve him with one consent. From beyond the rivers of Ethiopia, my suppliants. From beyond the rivers of Ethiopia, my suppliants, even the daughter of my desperate, shall bring mine offerings. In that day shall thou not be ashamed for all thy doings, wherein thou hast transgressed against me. For then will I take away out of the midst of thee them that rejoice of thy pride, and thou shalt no more be haughty because of my holy mountain. I will also leave in the midst of thee an afflicted and poor people, and they shall not trust in the name of the Lord. The remnant of Israel shall not do iniquity, nor speak lies, neither shall a deceitful tongue be found in their mouths. And they shall feed and lie down, and none shall make them afraid. So rejoice at the people's salvation. Sing, O daughter of Zion. Shout, O Israel, and be glad and rejoice with all the heart, O daughter of Jerusalem. Verse 15. The Lord hath taken away thy judgments. He hath cast out thine enemies. The king of Israel, even the Lord, is in the midst of thee, and thou shalt not see evil any more. In that day it shall be said to Jerusalem, fear thy not. And to Zion, let not thine hands be slack. What that mean? The Lord thy God in the midst of thee is mighty, and he will save. He will. And he will rejoice over thee with joy. He will. And he will rest his love. And he will joy over thee with singing. And I will gather them that are sorrowful with the solemn assembly, who are of thee, to whom the reproach of it was a burden. Behold, at that time I will undo all that afflict thee, and I will save her that halted, and gather her that was driven out, and I will give them praise and fame in every land where they have been put to shame. And at that time will I bring you again, even in that time will I gather you. For will I make you a name and a praise among all the people of the earth. When I turn back your captivity before your eyes, said my Lord. And that is the end of the reading today. And that was good, child. That was so good. We read the book of Zephaniah, chapters 1 through 3. Three things that caught my attention. Chapter 1, verse 6. And them that are turned back from the Lord, and those that have not sought the Lord, nor inquired for him, hold thy peace at the presence of the Lord God, for the day of the Lord is at hand. For the Lord hath prepared a sacrifice, and he hath bid his guests. That caught my attention. Chapter 1, verse 12. And it shall come to pass at that time that I will search Jerusalem with candles and punish the men that are settled on their less that say in their heart, the Lord will not do good, neither will he do evil. Let me repeat that for you guys and for myself. And it shall come to pass at that time that I will search Jerusalem with candles and punish the men that are settled on their less that say in their heart, the Lord will not do good, neither will he do them evil. That caught my attention. Chapter 2, verse 3. Seek ye the Lord, all ye meek of the earth, which have wrought his judgment, and seek righteousness, seek meekness. It may be that ye shall be hid in the day of the Lord's anger. That caught my attention real big. And I kind of want to share a story of why I think that caught my attention. And to anyone who is under God, you know, you can give me feedback and advice, because I'm trying to understand the Bible. And maybe we can help each other. But this young lady was in a city. Her and her homegirl, they were out. They were having fun. They were actually out on vacation. And they were enjoying themselves. But she just felt like it was time to go. At this point, it was time to go. So her and her homegirl, they left. Within the next hour, the city was bombed. And when the young lady was telling her story, she was so shocked. Because she was like, we were just there. We were just there praising God. We were having fun. It was a good time. And I left. Something told me to leave. And it was bombed. And how God saved her and her friends' lives. And so when I saw verse 3, chapter 2, seek ye the Lord, all ye meek of the earth, which have wrought his judgment. Seek righteousness, seek meekness, and it may be ye shall be hid in the day of the Lord's anger. Now, I don't know why those two may correlate, but something about that says God got your back. But I also know that once your mission is complete, that your time may be up. For example, our Jesus, our Savior, he didn't live long. You know, he didn't die, but he departed in his 30s. I can speak on so many other amazing people as well, but I'll just keep it at Christ for right now. That is the end of the reading of the word today. I love you guys, man. And you know what else? I love me. And I'm thankful for me for doing this and trying to change some stuff in my family and trying to break some curses. And building wealth, that's what I'm about. So I'm thankful for my sacrifices and for my discipline. Life ain't easy, but I'm doing it. I love you guys, and I'm out.
You can't be everything to everybody. I want to be your lover, your best friend, your Batman, Spider-Man, fight to pilot, shooting out your rivals, and I want